If you ask anyone on the internet where to go to watch content online, the first thing they'd likely say is YouTube for videos, TikTok for short content, Twitter for hot takes and politics, and of course, Twitch for live streaming. Twitch has been around forever, starting in 2007 as Justin.tv, which I didn't know until recently. Then changing names to Twitch in 2011, getting bought by Amazon in 2015, and here we are now, 2021. It's a place where iconic streamers make and break their careers, some getting hundreds of thousands of concurrent live viewers and more Twitch Prime subs than I could count. And these past few years, Twitch has gotten themselves into some pretty serious controversy, and other platforms are catching up. So, for those of you that don't know, Twitch has been doing a lot of questionable things these past few years. First of all, copyright and music. Basically, they've been forcing streamers to delete years and years of backlogs of different clips and VODs and all sorts of content on there just to prevent getting basically just DMCA strike downed. And this was without warning. It just happened. And some people had to go through years and years and years of clips just to protect themselves from copyright. For those of you that don't know, for years, people didn't really have a concern with copyright on Twitch. It's like, well, let's play some copyrighted music because the VOD's getting deleted anyway, so why not? But that's been changed very recently, and a lot of people got screwed by that one. We all know about their extremely corrupt leadership as well. They have a history of banning streamers for one reason, and then you'd have some big streamer that does the same thing, and they just turn their heads the other way. They ignore it. And a big example of this is things like hot tub streams, which is so annoying, by the way. So it basically started with female streamers. How do I say this without age restricting this video? They would show a little more than usual on their stream, and basically they would take donations and then they'd maybe bend over to pick something up, being overly dramatic. Maybe they would try to touch their elbow to their shoulder or something, and then, you know, they do all sorts of things. Some really down bad people on the internet will pay money for a pretty girl on Twitch to say their name and that sort of thing. And that went on for quite a while and got a ridiculous viewership to the point where the top of the website wasn't even gaming anymore. And it was just softcore prawn. Anyways, what they decided to do was finally ban it. But then what happened was they left an exception to the rule of showing explicit content. The exception was if there was a hot tub or a pool or any water, right? If they were in a body of water, then it would make sense to, you know, not have as much clothes. So with these hot tub streamers, as they're called, would do the same thing they were doing before, except they'd be sitting in a hot tub or a kiddie pool and there'd be floaties and they'd be doing the same exact thing. And then some of them have been doing ASMR. There's this famous clip of go farting on a microphone for money. I don't understand it because, you know, there's many websites on the internet for it. Maybe because Twitch is considered a safe platform, it's not as sketchy as other websites. Yeah, that's a yikes. And the fact is, Twitch is not doing enough against this. I mean, if you go on Twitch right now, I bet you there's streamers like Amaranth that are still doing this. Some iteration of it, I'm sure. And they get banned, get a slap in the wrist, basically, and then they come back a few days later better than ever because of the drama from getting a ban off of Twitch. All these people are talking about them, including me, I guess. I'm part of the problem. And then as soon as they return to streaming, there's even more people there to see it. In my opinion, this platform was made for gaming. Now, there's no problem if you're doing it just chatting, you're just, like, you know, interacting with your fans or whatever. But if you're starting to do stuff like that, there's other websites. I made a joke on Twitter. I was like, you know, at this point, they should just embrace it and make justchatting.tv. And then that'd be the place where all that happens. But I think the problem here isn't really so much the fact that this stuff is being streamed at all. The problem is that it's being streamed on a platform that, again, has probably a younger audience, a more gaming-centric audience. A lot of the advertising is geared towards gamers, and I don't think brands like Coca-Cola, for example, would be very comfortable having their ad played right before watching a girl fart on stream onto the microphone. I don't know. That just seems it seems like a big problem to me. Anyways, I've also seen things like streamers getting trolled by fans. Like, I remember this famous clip of, like, I think it was Pokimane opened up this link sent on Twitter or whatever, and then it was like, it was a Pornhub link and she didn't know, and it was like, ah, she screamed and like flung it off the screen, and just because it was on the screen for a few frames got banned or something. I know a streamer in the Skyblock space, his name's Akensoft. He was banned from Twitch because he was sleeping on stream because he was doing a subathon, and then a few viewers actually found a way to appear on stream. They got their Minecraft avatars on screen. And you could probably see where this is going. They changed their skins to some TOS stuff that I'm not going to mention, and then walked in front of the camera, and then he got banned because explicit content on his stream. It's so messed up, dude, that viewers have the power to take down a streamer by trolling, and Twitch does nothing about it. They just get banned. Like, it's not like their intention for that to happen. So there's problems both ways. They're not banning people they should be, and they are banning people they shouldn't be. Another example of Twitch not only being corrupt, but also vindictive, was that one time everyone remembers when Twitch got signed on to Mixer for millions of dollars so he wouldn't be streaming on Twitch anymore. And seemingly in response to that, you could see, you know, you could see the frustration from Twitch staff right on his page. Like, if you were to go to Ninja's Twitch page at that time, there'd be explicit content shown right on his channel page, which was likely placed there by a disgruntled member of the leadership. That's kind of a yikes. We still don't know the reason why Dr. Disrespect was banned after over a year. Twitch is also notoriously bad at responding to harassment, banning streamers for just saying specific words like simp. Like, banning a specific phrase doesn't work on a platform like this. All it promotes is people just harassing creators with a more detailed vocabulary. Toxic people won't stop being toxic just because they can't say a certain phrase. I mean, just go to r/destroyed by words, or what is it? Was it killed by words? I don't remember what it is. Probably the biggest issue that I've seen personally is one that goes unnoticed by a lot of people, and that's the poor discoverability for new or small streamers. Instead of an algorithm, Twitch discoverability is determined basically by how many viewers are already on stream, and then you're basically sorted, right? Any stream of a particular game is thrown into this list, and it's sorted by who has the most viewers, who has the least viewers. So there isn't really much of an opportunity to grow unless you know people and get lots of shoutouts and raids, or you just get extremely lucky with a random raid out of nowhere, or people scrolling far enough down the list. And there's no thumbnails either, so it's not like you can, you know, tip the scale in your direction. I can see not having thumbnails as a benefit as well, but I guess for new people, it is definitely a downside because there's no way to really distinguish your stream from someone else when they're just clicking around. One thing I personally hate about Twitch as well is their exclusivity policy. Again, it's something that not a lot of people talk about. For about 6 months, I was streaming on both YouTube and Twitch at the same time. I was having an awesome time. My Streamlabs was doing notifications for Prime subs and Super Chats within 30 seconds of each other. I wanted to have the highest chance for my stream to be picked up because, you know, at the time, I was just starting out, really, with having, well, not just starting out, but it was just starting to blow up, like my YouTube mostly. But I wanted to have an audience on Twitch as well. But as soon as I hit partner requirements, the rules in the contract said that Twitch would own my content for 24 hours and that I would not be able to repost it anywhere until then. So what I did was I accepted the partner contract and then just quit streaming on Twitch. It's not the most ideal thing, but the problem is I also discovered that affiliate has the same clause, and I didn't know that at the time, but I know now. So basically, Twitch is like, it's just like, you're not allowed to use your own content off platform. That's not cool with me. I disagree entirely. And that's why I don't stream there anymore. That's my reason. But anyway, all of these factors leave an opening for another website to take the top spot for streaming on the internet. And yeah, there's a big push from Facebook to promote Facebook Live or Facebook Gaming, whatever it's called, but it really isn't something I'm taking seriously. I don't think other people want to take it seriously. Facebook just seems like this creepy Big Brother type thing that steals all our data and is like, it doesn't, it just seems old, outdated. I mean, sure, they own Instagram, but like, I don't know, man. Mixer also, I mentioned that before, they actually shut down, which makes me wonder what happened to Ninja. Did he just pocket a ton of money and not have to stream on Mixer for several years? That's massive W if that's the case. And, you know, DLive never kicked off to begin with. But yeah, there's really no competition there except for YouTube. So it turns out that YouTube is coming up as one of the biggest streaming platforms on the internet. It's at least tied with Twitch nowadays. I mean, to my audience, to people that have been watching every video on my channel, they'd be like, well, duh, every video you make basically is a stream highlight. Well, yeah, I know. I've been streaming on YouTube for like four years. But I think now as a platform, it's finally starting to kick off. Here's some reasons why. YouTubers who only upload videos could start streaming and benefit from the audience they already have, instead of trying to push another platform on them, for example, promoting a Twitch stream. So just streaming on platform on YouTube would get you a lot more viewers if you're already on YouTube. And it also promotes videos and streams with an algorithm. Now, I know an algorithm has a lot of downsides. It makes it difficult to keep up with the trends once you do get somewhere, but you can't deny if you play the algorithm right, you do the correct title and thumbnail, make something really interesting, has a high click-through rate, high amount of watch time, the video is going to get views. And in turn, if you do that with a stream, or you make a bunch of videos and then start a stream, you'll get viewers on a stream. So in general, YouTube's a lot easier to actually start out on compared to Twitch. But yeah, that being said though, Twitch still does have an advantage in almost every other way if you consider things like Prime subs and gifting subs and all the emotes and having like that environment, right? But YouTube is capable of change. Just this past like month, they added subscriber only mode to streams, which is a huge feature. Now, it's not like Twitch subs, right, to pay for them. It's a YouTube sub where it's free. It's like a follower only for Twitch. But that was huge, especially for someone like me who streams almost every day and uploads almost every day. I immediately saw a 3x increase in the amount of subscribers on my channel just from making that change. They added clipping to channels. I was one of the first channels ever to test out the clips feature. And more, if I go to different channels on YouTube, I will see this clip feature. I was one of the first 7 channels to test it. It was really cool. But anyways, they're adding new stuff like, it seems like once a month at this point. At first, there's clips, subscriber only mode. I think I'm seeing more channels nowadays with the applaud feature, which is basically super chats, but for comments, which could be really nice for videos. You know, I've been talking a lot with the live stream team directly. I actually managed to slip in a call with them because my YouTube partner manager has connections. And they look up to me as someone that streams a lot, uses their service a lot, and has a valuable opinion. So what I'm about to show you guys is a document. Well, I'm going to read it out loud for you. A document that I sent them for suggestions to change the platform. I am a huge believer in this. I think YouTube could beat Twitch as the number one platform, and here's how. So first of all, small changes. The live control panel chat is roughly 5 seconds behind the viewer stream chat. Little change, but you know, it would make sense to have your chat update on a more updated basis. I don't know why it's a 5-second delay just for the panel. Like, what I could do is I can open the panel, then have a separate tab for the stream and get my chat quicker. Not sure why that's a thing. Anyways, there's a few little features I'd like to see when you click on a chat member's name. Right now, you can't do that if you're a viewer because there used to be these bots in YouTube chats that would promote, you know, explicit content. And then people would click on their channel and then get sent to scams and stuff. But they actually got rid of that, YouTube, by making it so you can't click on channels anymore. That being said, though, it would be nice if the mods were allowed to do that still, or the stream owner themselves. Like, let's say a friend of mine is in chat and I want to mod them. There's no way to know if they're the real them, so that would be nice. Also, it'd be nice to have a more complex ability to search through super chats, like search by viewer, date, contents of the message, you know, that sort of basically the normal comment search, but for super chats. Those are really little things, right? It barely changes anything. Twitch is still very far above YouTube in terms of features, but YouTube, like I said, has the viewership advantage. So what's going to get the viewers to interact more with the stream and make it more valuable to the streamer? Well, I think the first one is going to be a leaderboard for who donated the most through let's say Super Chat or members. Maybe you can rank the top member people, because they did express to me, they told me that gifted memberships are coming. That would be big. Gifting memberships is a great way. It's again, basically gifted subs from Twitch. It would be a big game changer. Some, what I would like to call whales, would contribute a large percentage of a streamer's income by donating a bunch of memberships to other people in the chat. So having a leaderboard for who did the most of that would be really cool. I know you can technically do this with things like Streamlabs and Stream Elements, but it would be cool if it was on site. I think a theme that's going to come from this is that it's really difficult to make a call to action actually work unless YouTube has a built-in system for it. For example, I could tell people to subscribe like every 5 minutes on stream. It'd be pretty annoying. I actually have a bot that does it in my chat, Nightbot. But it didn't do anything. But the second that I would turn on sub only mode, people wouldn't be able to chat unless they're subscribed, and it's free, so why not? So then it just massively boosts the amount of subscribers. It also would be a good idea to track the watch time of each player and to give the ability for the stream to award points to viewers for the amount of minutes watched. So I think the best way to describe this would be channel points on Twitch. So tracking watch time, being able to redeem those watch time minutes and use them for something would be really cool. For example, turning on emo only chat for 30 seconds, or reminding the streamer to take a sip of water, or having some effect on screen automatically. It would be, or to highlight a message, that'd be really nice. Start a poll, which YouTube already supports polls, so why not have one built in? They did it with the cards, but they got rid of it for some reason. Play a stream effect, that sort of thing. It would also be nice if when a streamer streams that their VOD automatically be added to a playlist called Past Stream VODs. They already have a playlist like this for uploads. Every upload you make automatically is put in the uploads playlist. Why not do the same for VODs? That would be very convenient. Another problem I had back in the day when I had pretty terrible internet is that if my internet cut for a second, the stream would die, it would buffer, and then if it buffered for too long, people would just get autoplayed out of the video, which is a yikes. So it would be nice if there was like a be right back screen that you could set, maybe like a 2 minute video that could play. It'll say something along the lines of technical difficulties, we'll be right back, the stream isn't over yet, stay tight. That'd be nice. You know, Twitch does something similar to that right now. Another thing that I think is essential, and this would be the biggest game changer out of all of these so far on YouTube, would be the ability to raid other streamers. Why is this not a thing yet? Right now, to raid, you basically need to spam your own chat with a YouTube link, which is not ideal. And I know there is a somewhat similar raid system. There's like it's half implemented. There's a system where you can raid one of your previews or another one of your stream, or not previews, a premiere. But I haven't figured out how to get it to work properly yet. It's not really well implemented. So I think a more sophisticated raid system, it would be cool to be able to raid a video or a premiere or another streamer, but from someone else. That would be huge. And here's a pretty complicated suggestion that I think would be awesome. Remember what I said about call to actions being really important? Well, what if you could set your own custom call to action called a stream quest? This would be specific to each stream, specific to each streamer, and that streamer can make a call to action during the stream and then encourage the chat to do it. The encouragement would come from the fact that a viewer that does the stream quest and, you know, successfully does the thing, then their name gets a special icon next to it, or it's highlighted in some way, and then there'd be an overlay in chat that would, you know, present the option to fulfill the call to action. For example, you could have a stream quest to subscribe to the channel, and then, you know, people subscribe. Another stream quest would be to leave a rating, like a like or dislike. And then once they've done that, then let's say that someone sets a stream quest to leave a rating on the video. I think it's important to say leave a rating, because just promoting liking the stream only could be inaccurate. So leave a rating either way would have it so that your stream quest is fulfilled and then you get a special highlight in the chat. That'd be really cool. Another call to action could be just commenting a certain amount of times, just saying something, Or maybe if you're a member, you get to show off a specific emoji. Or becoming a member could be a stream quest. Anything like that built in is going to increase the amount of people that actually fulfill that call to action by at least 5 times. I remember I tried promoting a Patreon for 6 months, and it was a well put together Patreon. It looked really nice. It had a bunch of cool rewards for each tier. I ended up only getting about 10 people maximum as supporters on Patreon. But then as soon as I took all of those benefits and converted them into YouTube membership tiers, I now have over 300 members. That's a 30 times increase. Just because it's on platform, it actually is the same amount of money as the Patreon tiers were per month, but people are on platform, so they're more likely to actually fulfill the call to action. So making an easy, streamlined way to do that would be huge. And of course, that highlighted name would only last during that stream. If the stream quest is to like the stream or, you know, leave a rating, so like or dislike the stream, then of course, as the stream ends, then the stream quest is done. It only applies to that stream. So the next stream, there'd be a different quest that you could do. Another thing that would be nice would be a more complicated auto mod similar to Nightbot. And there's a few features that Nightbot currently lacks right now that I would love to see in a YouTube auto mod, like a coordinated spam protection. Sometimes chat will decide all at once to say the same thing, and it could really mess with chat and make it really difficult to read. Like everyone could say, for example, slash gear was the first time this ever happened to me, and the whole chat would be slash gear, like every single message, and there'd be hundreds of them, all from different people, and there's just no way to moderate it with a bot other than auto mod, which doesn't exist. Having an easy way to blacklist certain phrases would be nice if they were auto modded immediately from the chat. I know there's a way to do this for comments, but I want it for live stream chat. Also, some spam protection would be nice. You know, if the same person says the same phrase 3 times in a row within X amount of seconds, mute them. Like, slow mode is nice, but it's still annoying every 15 seconds to have somebody say the same exact thing for 30 minutes. This happens, and there's no way to get rid of it with a bot right now. I don't know why, because it's a very simple problem, but it's something that's really annoying. Also be nice to have a chatbot API to help with making custom bots, because right now it's a little rudimentary. Anyway, another huge one that I think would change the game would be a competitor to Twitch Prime. Now, the impact on streaming income for YouTube and creators would be insane. So the problem with YouTube memberships is that the value proposition for YouTube Premium is terrible. For the price, what you're offered is just not worth it. Amazon, Twitch has free shipping on almost everything they sell, and it has free media through Amazon Prime Video. And there's other benefits you'd get as well. For example, every month you get a free Twitch Prime sub, which is an incredible value. But the problem with YouTube Premium is you don't get ads, which, I mean, Adblock exists. I mean, I'm a YouTube Premium subscriber, but that's only because I want to support my own platform. Most people would never get YouTube Premium. What is it, $15, $16? Whereas Twitch Prime is less than that, I'm pretty sure. And that's for free shipping on stuff that you, like, physically get in the mail. Like, there's no reason to have YouTube Premium. So here's my solution to that, right? I think YouTube Premium needs an upgrade. Again, for the price, it's just not worth it. Because, ugh. So what I think would be necessary would be, first of all, a more competitive price. So let's say $10 a month, $9.99, right? Possibly offer a discounted price if you pay annually or if you're a student, that sort of thing. And I think the thing that is going to get more people on YouTube Premium is going to be offering free movies each month. Imagine the ability with the catalog YouTube has to watch any movie you want for free 3 times a month, and it'd be anything. The problem I have with Netflix right now, right, is that they don't have, like, let's say I'm like, oh, I really want to watch Groundhog Day right now. You search it up, oh, it's not available. Okay, what about a different classic? I want to watch Alien. They don't have it. Want to watch Back to the Future? They have that one. I want to watch The Walking Dead. Not on there. It's mostly old movies, I think, would be the main draw. Or, like, episodes of TV shows that maybe are, you know. But anyway, I think the value that comes from YouTube movies right now is the fact that right now you can get almost any movie in existence. You just have to rent it for a few days for like $4. But what would happen if you could pick three of any movie you want to watch as your free YouTube movie for that month? It'd be three of them. That's a great value. That'd be like, what, $3.33 a movie per month? And that's about the same price as renting, actually. And then there's inevitably going to be people that forget to watch three movies a month, so they pay that value and it comes back to YouTube as just more money. So I think giving three free movies a month for YouTube Premium would be huge. And then obviously, alongside YouTube Premium, you would give a free $5 credit for a membership to any YouTube channel. So if their membership tier is $5 or less, you can get a free member. So it'd be like Twitch Prime, but it'd be YouTube Prime or whatever it would be called. And I think they need to work on the name member. It's very, it just doesn't sound right. Twitch Prime sounds good. Now it's Prime Gaming, but maybe like, I don't know. I remember Fezzy said something about like, instead of bits on Twitch, it'd be chips. Like YouTube chips, like chipping in sort of thing. It'd be nice. I don't know. And then finally, the last feature I would suggest is some way to do a hype train like system. I love the hype train system on Twitch. It's a cool way to remind everybody to use their Prime subs and to unlock some emote or something. YouTube could benefit from that as well. Well, anyways, that's it for this rant. This was a long one, 28-minute recording. I don't know how much of it's going to get cut down. But anyways, this is how I think YouTube can finally pass Twitch as the number one streaming platform on the internet. And I'm a huge believer. I know people give YouTube a lot of crap because it's like a big business that's hard to really get in contact with. But I think they're changing that, honestly. Again, I've spoken to the team myself, and it's not like I'm some huge creator. I only get like 100,000 views a video maximum. Like, there are people, like, I'm pretty sure Technoblade doesn't even talk to YouTube. Like, but anyways, I'm really hopeful, and I hope that YouTube actually listens to me on this one. Of course, I'm sending it to them. This whole list I already sent to them. But if you like the video, then leave a like down below. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. And I guess that's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later.